Hi guys! So when I did my unboxing of Shaggy, I said that I'd be back with a review, and it is something that I have been thinking about. But you know what? There's already so many good reviews of Shaggy on YouTube. So I still want to do a video involving Shaggy, but just with a slight twist. So today we will be comparing Shaggy next to Diptyque Volutes. These two have some notes in common, such as tobacco, honey, iris, and a light touch of leather. And there's actually a bonus third option, and that is Baekilan Back to Black. So when I can't decide which perfume I like better, or I just want to see their similarities and differences, the best thing to do is to do a side-by-side comparison. So that's what we'll be doing today. So what I have going on here is Shaggy on this wrist. And over here, I have Volutes in the Eau de Parfum concentration. And right here, I have Baekilan Back to Black, which I will be talking about just very briefly. So let's start with Shaggy and what it smells like to me. So Shaggy is honey that is sweetened by floral notes. And then the honey is folded into tobacco leaves and a light touch of leather, but it's the use of hay and musk that really sets this one apart and it makes it very unique. Shaggy is the name of the wind that blows through the Moroccan desert, and the use of hay and musk is quite clever because these two act as a cooling element, and it acts much like a wind that blows through a desert. And so in the dry down of Shaggy, what you get is sweet sandalwood and amber, and that pretty much sums up what Shaggy smells like. So now let's move on to Volutes in EDP. So Volutes is honey that is drizzled over spiced dry fruits, and what you get in the bag is a light touch of leather and tobacco leaves, and Volute means swirls, and that's quite an apt name for this perfume because although it's full-bodied, it never feels dense. It just has a swirliness quality to it, and the iris in the composition really softens it. And let me talk about my experience wearing these two. So when I wear Shaggy, I prefer it in weather that is 45 degrees or below. It really smells better when it's quite cold out. And when I'm in the mood for Shaggy, it hits all the highs and it smells wonderful, and especially when the temperature is just right. Now when the weather heats up, like say it gets up to 55 degrees or beyond, it starts to get quite powdery, and that effect really bothers me. And when I'm not quite in the right mood for it, it can cause me a headache. And like I said, when it hits the highs, it's very, very, very good. There are lows here. And in comparison to wearing Volutes doesn't quite hit the highs like Shaggy does for me. It stays somewhere in the middle. It's it always feels comfortable to wear. It's wearable. It feels modern and chic. So Volutes is quite a bit sweeter than Shaggy, and the two honey notes are very distinct from one another. In Shaggy, it's more like a honey sugar cube, Whereas the honey used in volutes feels like a sticky, dripping honey. And when the two are placed next to each other, they smell very distinct from each other. And Shaggy, while still unisex, leans a little bit more masculine than volutes. And volutes is a more modern and chic and wearable composition to me. And let's talk about that third option, by Kilan, Back to Black. So the use of honey in By Kilan is it's a finer honey. It smells more refined, and it also leans more masculine than volutes. And the performance is phenomenal on Back to Black. It will outperform the other two by a long shot as far as longevity, projection, and sillage. So that is my take on Shaggy and Volutes. Which one do I prefer? While I admire Shaggy, I find that it's actually easier for me to wear volutes, and it's just feels more modern and chic, and it does lean a little bit more feminine. So if you've tried one of these, let me know your thoughts, or just let me know how you're doing, and I will see you next time. Bye.